let's figure out the volume of a certain solid of revolution. For example, let's think about this region inside here, the region that's below the graph of y equals the square root of x and above the graph of y equals x squared, just this little wing-shaped region inside here. And let's take that region and rotate it around the x-axis. When I take a region in the plane and rotate it around an axis, I get a solid of revolution. And the question is, what's the volume of that solid? Well, let's cut this region up into little tiny thin rectangles, and then instead of rotating the whole region at once around the x-axis, let's just imagine rotating each of these little rectangular pieces around the x-axis and then adding up the volumes of those pieces. What do these little rectangles become when I rotate them around the x-axis? I want to take one of these little thin rectangles and rotate them around the x-axis. So just to get a picture here, let me just isolate a single rectangle and imagine taking this thin rectangle and rotating it around the x-axis. Well, what would happen when I do that, right, is that I'll end up getting a shape that looks a bit like that, right? That shape we're going to call a washer. What's the volume of a washer? Well, let me make this picture a little bit bigger. Right, here's a big picture of a washer. And what are the kind of parts of a washer? Well, a washer's got a thickness, which I'm imagining to be pretty thin. So I'm going to call that dx. It's got a small radius, which I'll call little r. And then it's got a big radius, which I'll call big r. Now, if I were just thinking about the whole cylinder of radius big r, I'd know the volume of that. Right? The area of a circle of radius big R is pi big R squared. So if I thicken that up, the volume of a cylinder of radius big R is pi big R squared, and the thickness here is dx. But then I'm drilling out this middle part here to make the washer. So I'm going to subtract from this the volume of this inside cylinder, which is pi little r squared dx. So this is the volume of just the washer, the part that remains. And I can write this maybe a little bit more reasonably as pi times big R squared minus little r squared times the thickness dx. Now I'll use that formula, the volume formula for a washer, to write down an integral that calculates the volume of the solid of revolution. Now going back to this picture here, I want to figure out the volume of, say, the washer at x. So I'll first think about what's the big radius. Well, the big radius here is on the red curve, right? That's the outside of the washer. So big R is the square root of x. And then the inside radius is on the orange curve, and that's given by x squared. So little r is x squared. And that's the outside radius and the inside radius in my washer picture here. Okay, now I just got to use the formula for the volume of that washer, right? And the formula for the volume of the washer there is pi times big R squared minus little r squared times the thickness of the washer, which is dx. What about the endpoints of integration? Well, in my picture, x could be as small as 0 or as big as 1. Right? I want to add up the volumes of washers for x between 0 and 1. So my integral is going to go from x equals 0 to 1. Now all that remains is to evaluate that integral. So to begin, I'll simplify the integrand a bit. This is the integral from 0 to 1 of pi times square root of x squared, that's just x, minus x squared squared, that's x to the fourth. I've got a constant pi. I'll pull that constant out. This is pi times the integral from 0 to 1 of x minus x to the fourth. And I just got to write down an antiderivative for that. So that's pi times antiderivative of x is x squared over 2 minus antiderivative of x to the fourth is x to the fifth over 5. I'm evaluating this at 1 and at 0 and taking the difference. But when I plug in 0, I don't get anything. So the answer is just whatever happens when I plug in 1. Which is pi times 1/2 minus 1/5. And if I like, I could write this as a single fraction. This is pi times 5/10 minus 2/10, or altogether pi times 3 tenths. So that's the volume of the solid of revolution. And we did it.